A manatee is back home tonight after a month-long recovery from a boat strike. Crews from SeaWorld released the sea cow into the Orange River.
So far this year, 1,017 manatees have died across Florida. That is more than 10% of the state's manatee population. NBC2's Alex Howard spoke to experts as the state hopes to step in and help solve this issue.
She's probably put on some weight, so I think she's closer to 400 pounds.
A 400-pound juvenile manatee is now free, a little over a month after she was hit by a boat off of Fort Myers Beach.
It's one of the best parts of the job, being able to come out here, especially like seeing the local members of the community be so supportive and be so happy to have a manatee returned. It is awesome.
Her recovery took place at SeaWorld in Orlando, where zoologists like Mallory McCormick helped her heal from 6 fractured ribs and fixed her ability to dive.
Be able to see a manatee come in with these injuries, rehab them to the point where they can go back. There's nothing better than that.
It's a heartwarming story amidst a crisis for manatees in Florida.
Anything that folks can do either on the West Coast or the East Coast to help out is critical at this time.
More have died here this year than ever before, and scientists are still struggling to understand why.
We know we've lost over 1,000 animals, which is by far the record in the state of Florida.
Only about 25% of manatee deaths in Florida are from boat strikes, and now FWC is asking for $7 million from the state in the hopes of understanding what's killing them.
When the issues are more complex, maybe it's seagrasses, maybe it's water, maybe it's the overall quality of the environment, it becomes a much more difficult task.
And while rehab efforts like this are ongoing, now many say more needs to be done to keep manatees from disappearing from our waters forever.
So I think the manatees really are a canary in the coal mine. They are telling us what's going on with the environment. When manatees are doing poorly, we've got larger issues with the overall environment.
Reporting in Fort Myers, Alex Howard, NBC2.